Hi guys, welcome back to ChargerLAB. Today we will tear down a pretty cool charger, the TEGIC 30W mini fast charger. Let's go! Firstly, the packaging is not like the ordinary chargers, but very unique, and all the specs are printed on the back. Remove the plastic film and the charger is in the middle. This is a little cube and it tops a matte surface. It has to use fixed pins because of the size. The TEGIC is printed here. Then let's see the specs on the button. Model is kernel 30. It supports input of 100-240V, 50 or 60Hz, 0.8A, and output of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 2.5A, 15V, 2A, 20V, 1.5A, 3.3 to 11V, 3A. Manufacturer is TEGIC. It only has one white USB-C port, and the LED indicator will light up after power on. Every single side of the charger is 29mm, a typical square. The weight is 34g. Compared with Apple 30W charger, the difference is obvious. It's almost a third the size of Apple charger. Then use the ChargerLab Power ZKT002 to detect the particle. It supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V, 2A, DCP particles, and QC23, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2, PD3, PPS fast charging particles. It also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 2.5A, 15V, 2A, 20V, 1.5A, and 1 PPS of 3.3 to 11V, 3A. Next, let's try to charge some devices. So let's take it apart to see if the internal design is as cool as the outside. The plug is directly connected to the PCB through contacts, and we can see lots of thermal adhesives inside. Then take out the entire module. It is composed of two small PCBs. They were combined by welding with an L-shaped structure. ChargerLab found that this charger adopts high-frequency QR architecture. The particle chip can control the output voltage based on optocoupler feedback. Then let's analyze all the components one by one. Here is the fuse, rated current is 2A. The common mode choke is wounded by double wire to filter out EMI interference. Here is a bridge rectifier. The I-shaped inductor is protected by insulation tube. Two electrolytic capacitors come from JSH Electronics. 400 volts, 27 microfarad. The master control chip is Southchip SC3021D, which is designed for 30W GaN charger. The GaN FET comes from Innoscience INN650DA04, which is the new product of 2nd generation Inno GaN series. It can achieve high frequency, high efficiency, very low loss, fast and active heat dissipation, etc. The specs is 650V, 480mΩ, and adopts DFN 5x6 package. Separate those two PCBs. Here are two LED indicators. This is the transformer. the CD1018 optocoupler is used for feeding back output voltage. The SMD Y Capacitor comes from TRX Technology, which is suitable for GaN chargers. If you're an old audience, you may see it often. The Synchronous Rectifier controller comes from Southchip SC3503, which supports adaptive turn-on detection and fast turn-off. It can be compatible with a variety of MOS and support multiple working modes. It adopts SOT23 package and is very suitable for the flyback power adapter. The model of Synchronous Rectifier is CSN10N9P5B. The solid capacitor is also from JSH Electronics, 25V, 470μF. The protocol chip adopts Injonic IP2723T, which integrates multiple protocols and has passed the PD3 and PBS certification. It can be used in power adapters and car chargers. The output VBUS switch transistor comes from Ruichips RU3040M. Its withstand voltage is 30V. And finally, this is the USB-C receptacle. Well, that's all components of this charger. The first word in my mind to describe this charger is cool. The appearance of this charger is very recognizable, and the size is pretty small. It supports PPS mode, that's to say, it can be compatible with iPhone 13 and Android phones. Because of the 30W, even the iPad and some small laptops can be supported. Okay, that's all for today's video, hope you like it. If you think it helped you, please subscribe to us and leave your comments. Your support is always our motivation. See you in the next video, bye!